Well guys, it's Thursday 28th October and I'm on my way down to Rainbow, but I've had a detour. I left a day earlier. I spoke to Tom Tebbit, who we'll catch up with shortly, who owns the zoo, and I've come round because the boys, there's a few of them on here this week. I was here more or less this time last year with Roy and the guys. So Tom knows, but the boys don't know. I'm joining them for dinner and staying the night. So I'm going to creep round and see Roy. He's in peg 18. But I'm also going to get him on the phone because he's just messaged me. He's had a 45. So I say, hey, Roy, well done. Boom, boom, boom. And then I walk in on the swim. Let's see how it works out.
All right, buddy. That's a nice fish. Well done.
But you're starting to get amongst them now, are you?
Yeah, but well, for Roy, it's one of those things, isn't it? Yeah. What peg are you in? Yeah. All right. You haven't moved then?
What are you doing there?
It's a surprise!
How are you, boyo?
Roy the Koi!
Fuck me, we're at me.
Roy was the Koi. Roy was the Koi.
All right, James.
Hello, Kevin.
Yeah, I couldn't resist the invite from Tom of dinner. Yeah?
That'll be
good to see you, buddy.
We've only got to put all these eating habits for one night and not a week. Philip Steaks
tonight. Did you know he was coming, Tom?
I knew he was coming.
A couple of days ago. Good to see you, mate.
Philip Steaks tonight, then.
Yeah. We're on it. Chili con carne, I'm told.
No, we've changed it for you.
Oh, you changed it?
Yeah.
It's amazing what the video does, isn't it? Yeah?
No, we're having curry.
Oh, yeah.
I fancy chili con carne.
Yeah, well, you look knackered. He said I'd be waking you up.
I'm just going to have a little snooze. Yeah, because we had a wrap in the night.
Right, yeah, yeah.
We had a couple of beers a few minutes ago. We thought, oh, we'd have a snooze.
I'll have another beer now. He's turned up.
Yeah.
Hard life, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, lovely. We'll catch up in a minute.
Well, that worked then. So it's nice to catch up with the boys. So I'm going to walk round now. The lake, it's a lovely lake, this guys, the zoo. Really is. We'll catch up with Tom, given the opportunity. So, like I said earlier, I'm just going to stay here tonight, not fishing or anything, just having a social with the lads, having dinner with them. Tom does great food, his wife. And then breakfast tomorrow, leave here mid afternoon, and I'm about a 3 hour drive to my hotel Friday night. But yeah, right now I'm going to go around and catch up with Rowan from Carp Lounge, who was fishing last week on the Island Lake, had a 67, another nice lake, and he's got a week with the boys here on the zoo. He won't be expecting me either. Surprise, surprise, Cilla Black.
Oh, hello.
Only a small world.
How you doing?
He said... Roy said to me, it's like Microsoft headquarters round here with technology. Yeah?
I'm just trying to work out if these...
Yeah, good to see you, Ro.
Yeah, you, mate.
Yeah, nice to see you, mate. What are we looking at here?
Seeing if there's a fish here. On there. There, no, that's weed, but...
That weed there, yeah. They look like fish,
don't
they?
Yeah. She's down in his... It's bait to me right, yeah. So I'll put bait out here, but just doing a bit of mapping on the V4.
So with all this technology, you should be having it off.
Yeah, should be. If I
so what
nothing.
Are you called?
Nothing.
You peaked last week. That was a nice result with the Island Lake,
nice.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, lovely.
Yeah, good things of that lake.
Yeah,
it's nice on the radar.
One of the big ones, yeah.
And you caught it 67.
60, yeah, just over 67.
Yeah, lovely, well nice done. Yeah, but struggling this week?
Yeah.
This is fishing for you, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, that's it, isn't it, at the end of the day? We've seen some out there, but nothing really. I mean, Lee's got them and George's got them down there, so.
Yeah. But yeah. Is Lee catching them from that side?
Yeah, he's catching them. Well, he's catching them between the two islands. He's had them off the bank here, And over in the, I think they call it Lovell. Is it Lovell?
Right, I know. So, yeah, I'll go over there and say hello.
But George had a 60 last night.
Yeah, nice. So Roy said, yeah, bang so. On.
Lovely.
Yeah, brilliant.
Yeah,
so, nice lake, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, lovely lake. Yeah, I'm joining you boys for dinner. I'm staying here tonight.
Oh, right, okay.
Having breakfast tomorrow, then toodling on my way down to Rainbow.
Oh, cool. Oh, right. Oh,
yeah, so I'm at Rainbow Saturday. Yeah,
yeah. Oh, yeah. Nice. We're down there for 2 weeks.
No, just a week. Oh, right. I was there only like 3 weeks ago. 3 or 4 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Scars
just come out, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. Yeah. From Peg 11 where I was fishing. Sean had that.
Sean had it, yeah. Yeah,
so there have been some good fish out.
Yeah.
There has been some good fish, especially this week.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, all at play for here, yeah?
Yeah, we have still 2 nights. Yeah. Birthday tomorrow, so.
Oh, is it now?
Yeah, I might get a fish.
How old are you tomorrow?
Still a hard paper.
Now, what are you? You've got to be, what, late 50s?
Fuck off.
How old are you then?
53, I think, this year.
50? Oh, yeah, you 53. Look older than that.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'll turn the video. I'll edit it out. Don't worry, Ron.
There's a guy up north, does them.
So you get a mould and then what?
Yeah, just pour lead in. You get the clips.
Oh, I see. So that is actually lead. I thought it was a stone.
No,
it's
that's
made
what it's
to look like a stone. Oh, and that's clever.
I colour them up like that because that's the colour of Island Lake, isn't it? It's got that chalky.
So you're making these here?
Only for myself.
Oh, right, yeah.
Myself. Yeah, and then
so,
I'll just...
So, there's an elite tackle, that's you, isn't it? Check out the website. Now, I always like to recommend good companies.
Thank you very much.
Yeah?
Thank you very much. Yeah, yeah, so, yeah, and they do drop in the margins in Ireland, like, they just completely disappear.
Yeah, look at that. That's clever, that is. You're a clever old stick, you are, aren't you?
Just like having a go, didn't I?
Yeah, good for you.
That's probably putting them off in here, because it ain't creamy clay in here, is it?
So you mapping this with your V4?
With a V4, yeah, with a new V4 system.
Yeah.
So, as soon as you press that button, with a mapping button, it shows you all the maps you've already done, so you don't overlap. So if you want to do sort of this area, you go one. So, you know, you can do that. Join it all up.
Yeah, so you know what the contours are like, yeah, and it's showing you the weed and all of that.
It doesn't show you the weed. With the next level up, we've got Structure Mapping Pro, which will show you the hardness, silt beds and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, so, you but know, you've got a down scan, the normal down scan.
Yeah, down
on the V4.
Side scan, yeah.
Yeah, so you can see the weed with that. You're talking about mapping, aren't you?
Yeah, this is mapping the contour. So
if
you go into, actually create the map, we're just there. I've mapped the... This bit is made up because it wasn't, I hadn't actually mapped it, but I've mapped it now so I can add it to
that. So you've mapped what's in yellow, so you ain't mapped this area?
No, mapped the whole thing's mapped.
Oh, is it?
All that, see?
Oh, you'll have everyone who's fishing here, won't you, now? You better put, you
that'll
better
be,
give
be screenshotting that when they pause the video.
Yeah, no, they'll be wanting that.
Yeah, so it's, but it's mad what it shows up.
And it just?
Yeah, I mean, you've got little, you know, like feeding holes here. Here,
yeah,
everyone's telling
up.
Me that, you know, off the end of that bar, that's where you want to pick them up towards that red tree out there, and that's, you know, this is the result of obviously everyone casting to that red tree at
Wraps,
you know, creating a spot.
Yeah.
And yeah, you map it, and it just, you know, just everyone thinks they know, but until you map it, and you find a little tiny little weed, you know, a little fading out.
And then you can mark that on your GPS in the boat.
You can literally just put your finger, you know, say you want, for example, you want to fish there, you put your finger on it. And then you can just call it whatever, like that.
And that's your GPS spot.
That's it. And it will come up there, and then you press it again, and you can just drive the boat straight to it.
Yeah, well, yeah.
You know, so
that's a lot simpler than the V4
than the V3. We've got it all on one page now.
Right.
You know, rather than being separate different pages, we've got old guys phoning us up saying how easy it is to use, you know.
It's good.
It's very intuitive how to use it, and once you've been shown, it's sort of...
Yeah,
it stays. You know what I mean? Because we've got.
If you can show Roy how to use it, anyone can use it.
We're going to get you,
me included.
That's it.
All right, we're on it.
No, we're there, then.
Yeah. Well, I've got 2 V3s now. You'll have to buy them back. Yeah. So just walking to Peg 3 where Lee's fishing. So Ro hasn't caught anything. Lee's had a nice few fish. Yeah. Lord, it looks good down here.
Yeah.
And George down there, then he's getting them.
He had a nice 60 yesterday.
Yeah. Lovely. Yeah. Doesn't it look good here?
That bush there.
Yeah.
Being sort of open water between the two islands out there. Every night been picking a fish off of there.
Yeah, it looks mad for it.
It's just no feature there, is it? It's just clear.
It's just clear. Like, you know, that's not a beach.
This is going to pick up the wind, but anyway, yeah, this is the view of from one angle of the zoo. Lovely lake, boys, isn't it?
Lovely.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just looking off camera there with Rowan. That V4 boat, and you've got to give it a carp lounge. that is a game changer. The way that maps, you know, for me, I get a lot of messages about boats when I feature them on the videos and stuff, and there's a lot of good boats out there, as we all know, you know, and everyone's got their preferences and that. But I've got to say that, yeah, that V4 and what Rome has just shown me. And I refer to Roy because Roy and myself, you know, between us, we ain't that savvy with all of this. But if you're fishing a week with Rowan, you know, you're going to get your head round it. As for picking up a manual and trying to learn it off YouTube, there's no substitute for just getting on with it, making a few errors and getting used to it. That's my, especially at that level, that's what I would say anyway. But it does look a lot simpler than the V3, that's for sure. So I'm just walking along the spit now to see George, who's in peg four. So I fished a few swims when I was here last year this time, and moved about and didn't do as well as I thought I would have done. If anything, I moved off the bloody fish, but anyway, yeah, I had a go in here. I like this swim. That's a sign of someone who's catching. He zonked out. I've gone in to swim. George! he's well out. So I'm with John now. So this is where Roy fished last year. Had loads out there. So you have had a go in here?
I had a go. I've done a couple of nights in here. Nicked one off the end of the island.
Yeah.
But it was just granite. I didn't see a fish up
there. Is anyone over there in that swim?
No one.
Right.
I'm over there now.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
I'm in eight.
Yeah. But yeah, one fish makes it a quiet week, but it can all change, can't it?
That's
yeah,
right.
It'll change, yeah, it is. Yeah, but coming back on here, like a year later, it is one lovely lake, this.
Mate,
I think it's about 60 acres, is it, Tom? I'll check with Tom.
But it's 45 acre lake.
45 acre lake, right, yeah, so yeah, it looks lovely. Yeah, so you've all had a bit of a move about then?
Yeah, well, with me and George, really, the other boys have stayed where they were.
Right, yeah.
A bit more patient, but... Yeah, there was nothing happening in there for me. As I say, I dropped a couple first night. I got a massive weed bed. I'm fishing the other side of it, but they're just going solid in the weed. So I just changed up a little bit today, come this side of it and try something else. But
yeah,
it's been really hard, mate. Really hard week.
Yeah.
From the one we had in June, so.
Look at that down around near peg eight. Like a castle, a bit of a castle left over. Probably the Romans done it a couple of hundred years ago. I'm just walking into peg 10, which serves to remind me I probably shouldn't have moved out of this last year. Anyway, another lovely pair. I think there's six of the boys on here this week. So look at this, peg 10. Water looks well clear. There's the clubhouse over there. That's the spit where Roy was catching his fish last year off that swim. I was round the corner facing the front of the lake. Yeah, lovely, lovely lake this, boys. Tom, can I just check there's no hormones in this? How good's this, boys?
Can't beat it, Kevin.
Yeah.
Can't beat it.
Nice fish in the night as well, Roy, well done.
Yeah.
Some nice fish out.
There's some lovely fish coming
out. Yeah, so we'll catch up with Tom in a little while. But yeah, breakfast time. Well, we're just going to catch up with Tom. It was a year ago. In fact, let's just put it on me. It was a year ago I was here with Roy during lockdown. We had a trip, managed to get out and had a nice cracking week here. So, like I said earlier, I've stopped here last night. I'm heading from here down to north of Bordeaux tonight to stay and then Rainbow tomorrow. But in the meantime, we'll catch up with Tom. Yeah, we've come inside, Tom. It's a bit windy out there.
Yeah,
and it's not
moving,
my line.
Moving
but
my hair around.
James said, did you sort your hair out for the camera? Which I did think
we're
was
ready.
Funny.
Yeah, we're yeah. ready. We're ready.
Tom, it's a year since we was here last.
Yeah.
And, you've kindly let me drop in and catch up with the boys before heading down the Rainbow. Tell us how last year's been locked down and...
Well, we're still here. That's the main thing. Yeah, we've survived. It's tough for everyone. It's been rubbish, but we've had half a year so far, and it's been really good. Lake's fished really well. The lads are keen to come back, which was always a worry with COVID. You sort of think, can people really be bothered to come to France? The effort, the cost of stuff, the tunnel prices seem to have gone right up. I think they'll come back down. But yeah, it's been, yeah, can't grumble really. We're still here, that's the main thing.
Yeah, and good for you. And in terms of keeping the fish fed and everything, because normally a lot of these lakes rely on the anglers' baits to sort of keep them in condition and getting bigger. How have you managed to deal with that?
I was feeding the aloe aqua pellets in the spring. I had a couple of ton from the previous year and just feeding them, and they were, with no fishermen here, they were going mental for the pellets, I must admit. But we're lucky here, we've got a big lake full of natural food here, and the fish were fine, really. I think they were happy, really.
And what are you going to do in terms of bookings for next year? Are you pretty booked up?
Yeah, we've got a little bit of space left. So if anyone does want to give me a message, and or groups still looking for probably 10 anglers we cater for a lake exclusive. There's a few weeks left in the summer. All the spring dates have all gone because nobody came from last year, so we roll them all over. And we only book for 12 months in advance. So I'm only taking bookings for next year, not 2023 yet, because anybody that fishes here gets the opportunity to keep their spot or place for the year after.
Yeah, which is good.
And yeah, a bit of a loyalty sort of thing.
And the winter fishing now, so in the past, you haven't really had winter anglers on here, have you?
Yeah, with a full summer, winter comes, to be honest, it's nice to have a break, give the fish a rest, let the swims recover, let the tracks, you know, get everywhere nice, ready for the spring. But I think this year, if people want to come out, especially the lads that have been here that I know, if people want to come out on a drive and survive basis, then yeah, they can come throughout the winter. Just send me a message if the weather looks right. Can we come out next week? Yeah, give me a message and come out and have a go. Because the winter fishing, it can be really good.
Yeah, that's useful to know. Mm. Yeah, okay then, mate, cool. Mm. All right, well, that's an update then. And the boys have had a nice week, caught some nice fish, haven't they?
Yeah, been some fish up to £60 this week. So, yeah, the good form continues as such.
Yeah, and your Facebook page is pretty much up to date.
Yeah.
So anyone wanting to keep up to date with the fish, you just go on Facebook.
Yeah, just look at that. Yeah, anybody wanting any info, just drop me a PM and I'll reply as soon as possible.
Yeah, happy days.
To see you, mate. Have a good trip down at Rainbow.
I'm looking forward to it, but equally, having come back on here yesterday and seeing how pretty this lake is, and like I said to the boys, you know, this is a lot bigger than your average size English-owned lake in France.
Yeah.
So what are we, 40-odd acres?
45
is it?
Acres.
45 yeah. acres, yeah, and it's a great size. It's a lovely lake.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you might just see me this winter. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Well, you look disappointed. Yeah.
I've seen you eating curry last night. I thought one night's enough.
All right. Yeah. Thanks for that. On that note. No, cheers, Tom.
Yeah,
thanks for that.
Come and have a go in the winter by all means.
Yeah, I think I'll do just that. Yeah. Cheers,
all
Tom.
Right, mate.
Thanks, buddy.
Well, 9 o'clock Saturday morning. Had a great night's kip at the hotel and just had a light breakfast. And I'm heading slowly down to Bordeaux. Get some shopping in and then get to the lake early afternoon, which is when we're allowed on now. So excited. And well done to you boys. I'll get a synopsis later of what went on the last 2 weeks, but there were some cracking fish caught by the boys. So well done on that. So right now, a couple of hours drive down to the lake. Well, it was only about 3 weeks ago I was at this spot on my way home. So, early afternoon Saturday, easy journey, sailed through Bordeaux, hotel last night, and I'm at Rainbow. So, I'll wait a little while to get in. Can't get in now till nearer 2 o'clock. Gonna have a cup of tea and chill. I guess the boys will be turning up shortly. Big changeover day today. So, and I'll try and run through what was caught the last couple of weeks once I've plotted up with the boys that were here the last couple of weeks. As I said earlier, done really well. But for now, excitement begins. Well, guys, just approaching 2 o'clock and I'm going to have a quick look down at the swim. And then I'm going to skirt about. Next time this comes out, I think will be the cup of tea moment. But come and look at this. So Dave Wibley's been in here 2 weeks. Martin was to his left in 18. They both had the same 78. And this is the scene. 1 week, peg 17 for the first time.
don't get much better than this in carp fishing, let me tell you. So let's make it happen.
Well, it's 4 o'clock and I'm about to start putting the rods out. And yeah, conditions just bang on. Low pressure that's finally come after a good few weeks. And yeah, looks good. So yeah, I'm going to be putting 3 rods out for tonight, which I generally do. And then keep the fourth out in case, you know, I need to put one out in the night somewhere where the fish are moving. So that's the plan at the moment. And that was a cutaway shot of Pete's bait, which is his nut bait, 24 mils. I've cut them in half and I've got some 18 mils with me as well. So just mixing up the sizes really, crushing a few, grinding a few, all the normal stuff. And we'll see just how much aggro the bream can be. But anyway, right now, going to get the 3 rods out. I'm staying off a cup of tea. I'm going to treat myself to a cup of tea when I've got the rods out. So yeah, it's dark about 7. Clocks go back tonight. So yeah, let's get them out. Well, just gone 4 o'clock and I'm putting my first rod out and I'm proper excited. So yeah, let's get them all out first and then we'll have a regroup and that cup of tea moment. Yeah, guys who know this peg will know, you know, a lot of people fish here and fish it different ways, like all pegs on all lakes. But for me, going right up into the shallower water is just too precarious for my type of fishing. So I'm fishing mainly the sort of, thanks really to Jordan and Kev and their experience in this swim, you know, fishing the deeper water, you've got more chance of getting them in, and not least of all, least worrying about branches and bits and bobs. So yeah, I'm fishing, you know, as it shelves slowly, I'm sort of fishing anywhere between 22 and 18 foot, I would say. But I'm just about to put the second rod out, first rod, you know, a spot that yeah, the boys have put me on, that yeah, when you go out there and you donk about, it's an obvious spot. And it's sufficiently far enough away from the, you know, or it, well, the snags. It's not the snags that you can see, it's the snags that you can't see. That's the issue at Rainbow, like all lakes, I guess. So that was 2/3 of the way across. You sort of got a hump there and then, you know, it'll start shortly edging up towards the island. Don't ever come to Rainbow without a donking rod, let me tell you. Well, boys, that was a hectic 3.5 hours. Half past 5, Saturday, got 3 rods out. The bells on the rod got me spots, I think, and the much needed cup of tea. So there's the rods, the boat in the middle, fourth rod will go out tomorrow or in the night. Bivvy about as close as I can get it, being able to walk back. I'm just making sure, keep this area free, that you get the bite and you're walking back, probably as far as Paris. Van's up there. And this is the swim Saturday evening, Ed's setting up. To the left, Martin from Holland, he's in 19. A couple of English lads I'll catch up with are in 16. They're out there now. So yeah, all to play for, boys. Don't get more exciting than this. Well, 8 o'clock Sunday morning. And it's not like we didn't hear any fish. Ed come down. About 8 o'clock last night, he hadn't got his rods out, he was putting them out this morning. We're sitting here
and in front of him it was like a paving slab was dropped from heaven. So that was enough for him to go back and put a rod out. And then I heard the odd fish in the night, but I slept well. And then this morning, about half hour ago, heard the bell before the buzzer, and I had a bream on the anti-bream rig. So that might need a rethink, we'll see. But yeah, right now, yeah, it looks to be a nice day, and yeah, I'll get the fourth rod out today. Probably in open water to my right, not as far down as that plateau area. The boys in 16 are coming up to that, and good for them. But yeah, I'll have a little venture down there rather than have all four rods over the back. So that's the plan at the moment. But right now, a couple of cups of tea, calm my nerves. And but yeah, when I heard that bell, yeah, I've got this camera, the DJI Osmo, and it's on like a loop. So I've got that. This is work in progress for me because I don't normally do this, but I'm going to give it a go. So that's recording every 5 minutes. Anyway, this is the scene. Sunday morning. Well, I just rebaited that rod I had the bream on. And I've got a feeling that could be my hot rod. That's the second rod from the right. I've not got the right hand rod out yet. I'm still sort of hedging my bets with that. Hey, a lot of kingfishers on rainbow this year. And last year. Yeah, it's nice to see. Yeah, just not sure about the fourth rod. It's tempting to put it over the back. But I just wonder, too many lines over there. Not least of all, you know, 16 on the Brazilian, as you would be. So, yeah, I'm keen to get the fourth rod out, but I'm not sure where to put it. I'm just holding fire at the moment and gonna have some brunch. Food helps the mind focus, hence my figure.
Mid-afternoon Sunday, boys have got one in 16. Off the Brazilian, I think. Yeah, it's a sturgeon. But a bit of excitement and good angling, lads, the way you handled that. Catch up with you in a week, come and have a cup of tea with you. Well, I had a little doze, thanks to this recliner chair I got off Roy. In fact, I stole it off him at the zoo the other day. It is so comfortable, 50 quid off Amazon. Trust me, boys, you won't be disappointed with that. Great bit of kit. Anyway, this is the scene, mid-afternoon Sunday. This rod's going out on the to the left of the Brazilian, over there. I'm feeling this rod, really am feeling this rod here. I'm thinking it'll be dark by 6 o'clock tonight.
Well, it was all nice and calm. I thought, perfect, I'll go and put the fourth rod out. Halfway across, storm, hurricane coming. Well, I'm exaggerating, but it stopped me baiting up. Yeah, it just come from nowhere. So I come back in, wimped it out. £62. There he is. Monday morning, 5 o'clock. Well, guys, let me tell you. Honestly, that fish I thought was a bream. It's my right hand rod, and Ryan at UB pop-ups, I owe you one, because I caught it on your pop-up, buddy. Thank you for that. Anyway, I had a bite about 5 o'clock. I pulled into it walking back. Oh, it feels like a bream. I'm winding it in. Got it into the margin. I played it in the margin for 15 minutes. It was just incredible fight, right under the watt tip most of the time. So I waded out up to my boxers to keep it off that sort of shallow pit in 17. I was just playing it there forever. But what a great fish to start off with, beautiful mirror. So yeah, well happy with that. So now it'd be light in a couple of hours, I'm gonna have a cup of tea, keep awake, regroup.
Perfect way to celebrate 62 mirror. Cup of Yorkshire tea. Oh, well happy with that. Well happy with that. Yeah, and the joys of fishing for carp. Yeah, I honestly wound that into the margin thinking it was a bream. Fantastic.
Well, I was umming and ahhing about putting that fourth rod back out, or that, well, I had the fish on back out. I had the four rods out from last night. And that was on the fourth rod that I put out. I think that makes sense. Anyway, but I'm gonna go for a shower this morning, about 10 o'clock. So, yeah, I haven't put it back out, rightly or wrongly. I must say I did um and ah. But anyway, so, yeah, go and have a quick shower, sort a few bits out, get back and get them back out again. But yeah, proper happy with that. A few cups of tea to celebrate, some breakfast in a minute. And yeah, great start to Monday morning, that's for sure. Much needed fish. Be interesting to see what's happened around the lake. Don't know if anyone's had anything else as yet. Yeah, let's see. But it's low pressure, 1,005. Overcast, had a lot of rain the last 24 hours, a lot of rain. I had to bail out the boat, a lot of water in there. Yeah, conditions do look good. I did start to wonder when it was quiet. I'm thinking, you start asking, is it the low pressure, the rain, the temperature drop and all of that? You know, you start disappearing up your backside. Because I've said before on the videos, when it's hot and high pressure, you want low pressure and wind and rain. And when it's low pressure, wind and rain and you're blanking, you want it hot. So that's the way it is. But right now, had a lovely fish and yeah, great start to the trip. Well, been up and had a shower, sorted some stuff out, feel much better for that. And back, skirted about as quickly as I could, and back, shared some apple pie with a few of the lads. Let's get them back out there.
Monday lunchtime. Views don't get much better than this.
Well, 3 o'clock now, Monday afternoon. So I had a bit of a regroup, had to wait to put my rods out. It was really windy and heavy showers we're getting. And due a lot of rain, I think, next 48 hours. But anyway, yeah, conditions look good. And I've got a spring in my step and I'm on it, so to speak. So, enjoying myself. I'm glad I've caught a fish. I'm fishing better now I've caught one, that's for sure.
Won't you tell me now?
Monday afternoon. Happy days, left hand rod.
Well, there was no messing about with that one. Left hand rod. I'm standing in front of it, in fact, and I heard again the bell a split second before the alarm, which grabbed my attention, and then bang, the rod was over. Picked it up, walked back, and yeah, managed to turn the Osmo on as well. So I think I've got some action on that as well. But the important thing is, got the fish in, just kept pulling, and yeah, 37 common, so well happy with that. Second fish Monday early evening. It's about 4 o'clock, half four now, I think it is. So anyway, yeah, well pleased with that. It's pissing down out there. Got me tunes, pizza on me Caddac. About 7:30 Monday evening. Can't see nothing out there. No moon. Black as you're at. All to play for. Well, Tuesday morning, and that rain was relentless. Really was heavy, and I think we're due quite a lot more rain over the next 24 hours. But the upside is, I had a fish this morning, not a big one, but it's great practice. The left hand rod again, probably about 8 pound common, typical little wildy looking male. But you know what, got the art going, and yeah, it was fun. But right now, just rebaiting that and preparing ourselves for more rain. So it's 3 fish now, but it's all to play for. Really am feeling confident. I'll find out what's going on around the lake today. I don't know if Ed has had anything, or the boys down in 16. I think there was one off the island. But again, like I've said before, you never know what's going on here. Someone next door to you could be having it off. You really don't know. But anyway, let's get the rod back out there. Just rebaited the left-hand rod. Just heard from Dennis, very quiet around the lake, very few fish out in fact. We drew a big temperature drop I think today, but here's what it is, get on with it. I'm just keeping the camera under the bivvy because it's peeing down. Got a lovely mirror, I think it's up a 30, beautiful mirror in the net, again left hand rod. Just gone 12 o'clock Tuesday, so well happy with that. But it's hammering down, so. Wow, that is one angry carp. I think that must be a male. It's in a sling. It's hammering down. I just got to compose myself. But yeah, crikey. That was a great battle. So, yeah, let's just regroup, sort my life out. Whew. .45-12. Only way to hold this fish. It's mad. Look at that. Beautiful fish. Come on, get you now. Yeah. .45-12. What a beautiful fish. Happy days. Lunchtime Tuesday. I tell you what, you don't take prisoners playing them fish off that far bank. And although I ain't right up close, you still feel the need to get them back off there quickly. So if anything, I feel like I'm bullying the fish
which means when you get them in the net and in the mat and everything else, they beat you up. Honestly, fish beat me up. But what a cracking mirror. 45-12, beautiful winter colour fish and all. Great shape. We're happy with that. 33-12. There we go. Happy days. Well, just seen a fish roll on the right hand rod where I just had that, I think it was 33-12, little dumpy mirror. And no sooner had I got that in the sling, I had a small mirror, about 12 pound. So anyway, yeah, gonna get the two rods back out again. And yeah, seems to be doing all right. Happy days. Just getting a perspective here. That's 16 over there. There's the Brazilian just round that corner. And I'm fishing in front of these in the deeper water. And this is the close-up off the Island of Pigs, 17. I've had seven fish now, seven bites. There's my other rod there, my left, my right-hand rod that's going to go out in a moment. And there's my swim over there. Well, just got all four rods out again, half past four Tuesday. I think we're due a thunderstorm. Just heard some thunder in the background there. Here we go again. Lamb and Dauphin Wild potatoes, peas and gravy. It's about 5 o'clock. And I'm eating early because it's all going to kick off. Well, just put back my eighth fish, common, upper 20. I was having my dinner, nearly saw my dinner again. But yeah, put that straight back. It's peeing with rain again, but I've got the rod back out there. It's going to be dark in 20 minutes. And yeah, all to play for. So yeah, it's turning out to be a good session for sure. Well, really good session. So yeah, be nice to get a real big one, but don't get me wrong, I'll be going home happy with that 60, but there's possibly a 90 pounder out there right now, so that's the ambition. Anyway, need a cup of tea. 8 o'clock Wednesday morning. That was a quiet night, didn't really hear anything either, but the rain, I've never bailed out the boat so much in any fishing trip, unbelievable. I'm gonna start crying. This is unbelievable. There's a game changer in my sleep. It's just gone 9 o'clock Wednesday morning, quiet night. My rod that I ain't had a bite on has gone over. I could feel it was a big one, I got it on the glasses, and when I saw it, I think that fish is 70 pounds. I absolutely made up. Unbelievable. So anyway, I need to skirt about. One of the boys from 16 is going to come up and give me a hand. It's a fish you need a hand with. So yeah, I can't even tell. I've got to have a cup of tea, calm me nerves. Nice one, boys. You're on it. Oh, not as big as I thought.
No.
Yeah. Oh, well. Got quite, no, 70 pounds, 60, so 68, 69 pounds, less for 65. Oh.
It's not exactly a small one,
no,
Kev.
No.
Still a big fish.
Yeah,
Kev,
yeah,
well
for
done.
Sure.
Yes, Kev, yeah. Well done. But yeah, the sling is less than 4 pounds.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd do, 65 pounds.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, if it's bigger than that.
That's a lot.
Look at that. Yeah. Happy days, I'm happy. Yeah. Yeah.
Well done, nice, Kev.
There we go. 65 pound. Well, happy with that. Super. Let's get the other side.
Excellent.
Yeah, you all right, Nick?
Yeah.
What a fish. And that's number 9.
Number 9, Dennis.
Excellent. Excellent.
What a session.
Yeah.
I'm well happy with that.
Brilliant.
Yeah, and I'll just get my classic shot.
Yeah.
Come on, boys.
Play the guitar. Rock and roll.
Thank you, fish.
Yeah.
What a beautiful fish.
Lift his head just a tad, Kev.
Oh. Yeah, guys. I'm
yeah.
Thank you very much.
Well done, mate.
Thanks a lot.
Top result. Top result.
Cheers, boys.
Thanks.
Yeah, well happy with that. Yeah, thanks so much for that. Cheers. Well, I must confess to having been caught up in the moment a bit with that fish, but you know what? 65 pound, what a cracking fish that was, and what a fight. So, not the 70 pounder I thought it was, but there you go, that's my excitement. Right now, just giving it a little while, winding in, going to have a shower, sort some stuff out, get back, got 3 nights to go. And 9 fish in, I couldn't be happier with that, let me tell you, especially with the way the lake's fishing at the moment. But it can change for anyone on this lake, on a sixpence, as we all know. So right now, another cup of tea. I've calmed down, I've stopped shaking, but I'm taking in the moment, that's for sure. Well, mid-afternoon Wednesday, gone up, had a shower, had some lunch, I'm back now, and I'm putting out just three rods, thanks to the advice of a couple of mates who know this swim well. And right now it looks like we're due some more rain. It's really getting dark over there, so I'm gonna get these out, sit back, relax and cherish the moment. It's been a great morning's fishing, been a great week so far, but still all to play for. This is rainbow, it's anywhere, come to that, but yeah, I'm proper on it. So, just gone 3 o'clock, Wednesday, three nights left. And yeah, what a swim to be fishing. And what a result I feel like I've had so far. Proper enjoying myself and in the element. Some blue sky and sun. Boy, do we need it. Well, result. Looks like there's no more rain now for the duration of my stay. I think I've seen enough rain so far this week. There's the boys baiting up in 16. Hopefully they start getting some fish. So the scene early evening Wednesday. And it is so quiet when it ain't windy and raining. I forgot how quiet fishing can be. Just gone 7 Thursday morning. That was a cold night. I've got everything on now. Hat, thermal jacket, extra jacket. But bite time. But here's some fish in the night down on my right hand margin. The boys' left hand margin in 16. I'll have a chat with them, see if they're down that area and if they heard them as well. We're approaching 9 o'clock when I had that bite yesterday. And the rod tips, they knock in the mornings. And you never know if it's bream, carp. You're reluctant to strike it because you then got to re-bait during bite time. It's like you're stuck between a rock and a hard place. But right now, yeah, the anticipation. You know, I'm on the ceiling. Do you know what? My phone just rang. I've jumped 6 foot in the air. mad swim. Well, I've just been up for the shower. It's midday on Thursday. And I put some bait out before I left. Bumping into some boys. The lake is very quiet. So you've got Ed, who's had the small one. You've got Martin, who had, I think, and his friend, 4 early on. I don't know about 21. I've just bumped into the guy in 1 and 2. They haven't had any. I've come round to 5, catch up with Pierre from France and his friend, who I've corresponded with on Facebook. So we'll pop into 5, say hello to the boys, and then I'll head round for lunch with Dennis and Martin. But yeah, I'm going to change the baiting strategy, I think, a little bit when I get back. Put less bait in. I didn't put a lot in just now, but I'm inclined to not be putting in a lot of bait. I think that's the feeling right now. Walking into 5, first peg I ever fished back in 2012. Don't seem that long ago. I just bump into Pierre.
Yeah.
In the shower, he's coming round. Yeah? You okay with the camera?
Yeah, good. Any problem. How are you?
Yeah, all good. Saying this is the first peg I fish in 2012.
And how you find then?
Yeah, I found it better subsequent trips.
Which period?
This is 2012, like May or June. I was fishing down here.
Summer.
Yeah, in the summer, my friend was on the left here, and but I fished it several times since. Yeah, this mist is hanging around. I was hoping to get the drone up today. Yeah, could do with the sun breaking through, get a bit of sun on our backs. Yeah, but nice to meet you guys. And Stu, here we are, the boys.
Hey, Stuart.
Yeah, Stuart. Yeah, we're talking about you. Yeah, so yeah, good luck next couple of days then, guys. Yeah,
hopefully it will be good. We've been struggling so far. Big drop of temperatures, but I think we are on the good spot. Maybe we have chances on the deep water to do something. So this is what we are playing now. Not any more margin or anything. All the lines in the 5 meters spots, and hopefully maybe.
Yeah, it can all change. All right. Well, good luck, guys. Keep in touch. Yeah.
See you.
All right. Thanks, boys. Yeah. Come around and see the boys in 7, 8, 9. Whew, that mist has finally cleared. Crikey, a nightmare that this morning. All right, boys.
Morning, Gav.
Morning, guys. Glad that mist has finally gone.
Yeah, couldn't even see my own hands.
You look perfectly at home there, the two of you. Yeah? Perfectly bedded in.
We've had time enough to settle.
Yeah, I see your sunset shots and stuff. Yeah, you're obviously bored.
Yeah.
Maybe not bored.
Scenery shots and food shots.
All of that, yeah.
That's about it.
Yeah. That tells the whole tale.
I've just been with the boys in 5, quiet for the day. I didn't go into 6, but in general, the lake's very quiet compared.
Bizarre. Yeah.
Maybe that sudden weather change, who knows? Yeah.
It must be, you know. 2 weeks ago it was 30 degrees, last week was 20 degrees, and now it's 10 degrees and the night's against freezing. So.
Yeah, yeah, it was cold last night.
Yeah.
One degrees this morning on the...
It was it? Yeah.
And all the cold rain, so...
Yeah. But anyway, we've got a couple of days to make it happen.
Still 48 hours.
Yeah. Am I just in time?
Here he is. Good
morning, Kev.
It's a good morning over here, as you might see.
Oh dear.
Go on.
Big Fish Thursday.
Go on.
I just had one, 68. 10 minutes later, he's got 74 and a half.
Wow. Brilliant.
Absolutely.
Bloody brilliant. Go on, you just taking the photos now?
Yeah. Good timing, Kev.
Alright, let's get a few more done, shall we?
Alright, we're
going to
pull this thing out.
Go on.
Keep him there for now.
Wow, look at that!
Beast. No bites all week.
Brilliant!
2 in 10 minutes.
Oh, what a beautiful fish that is!
Come on.
Look at that! Amazing!
Yeah, look at it, lovely. Keep him there.
Wow, boys, well done.
PB John.
Yeah, look at that. Fantastic. Yeah, fucking brilliant.
Thank you, mate.
Well done. Yeah, what a result. Yeah, congratulations on that. So, yeah, just chewing the fat, couple of sturgeon. Thinking it's never going to happen.
It's all over. Yeah. We were laughing about your story, how it was like, he waited 30 nights and then packed up and went home.
Yeah.
It's going to be us.
Yeah.
Oh, what buzz.
Yeah, fantastic. What a result.
Yeah,
brilliant.
Wow.
What did you do? Cast into my swim while I was out of the shower?
Yeah, well, you've been going long.
Yeah, fantastic. Yeah, superb.
Any more fishy last night, mate?
No, but like we said on the text this morning, I heard, you know when the sound travels and that, you're never quite sure where the fish are, but I thought what I was hearing was down your left margin. Mate, did I get that right?
There's a couple out here somewhere. We thought we heard some out tight there, but there was so much misting we couldn't see, but we heard them.
Right.
Absolute pigs.
Right, yeah.
Probably them two.
Yeah, probably them, yeah. So how big was that one?
74 10.
74, wow, brilliant. And what a great looking fish.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I think Nick has said he's been coming a few years and that's the one he was really after.
I've seen it a few times.
You have you? Yeah, wow, yeah, brilliant. Yeah.
Lovely to see that one.
Yeah, superb. Yeah, great result.
Whatever happens now.
Yeah, bang on. Yeah, that's rainbow, isn't it? Yeah.
You said, didn't you?
Yeah.
All changes,
like, yeah, change on a sixpence.
That's not a million miles off that.
Yeah, look, there's one there and all, look. Do you know what? I need to go and get me rods out. What I do is have a look at your rigs, right?
Yeah,
I'm in, look. Is that what you call it, on the bollocks rig?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice one. Yeah, well done.
Is yours on the bollocks as well, Spen?
Scopex squid, yeah.
Squid for the win again, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, nice one, boys. Anything else I need to know? Any secrets that I can always edit out? Yeah.
I think we were going to come round to you for secrets.
We sat there thinking, there goes Kev, he's got another one.
Yeah.
Send out the text, Kev, rig school at peg 17 with Kevin Ellis. Send it out to all the boys.
Blinding result. Well done, guys.
Lovely, thank you.
Yeah, happy days.
Oh, cheers for coming round as well.
Do you know what? I was going to come round and give you €10 for the donuts, but I ain't going to pay you now. You don't need paying.
They're on
you. Yeah.
Well, what a great result for the boys. One fish each within a few minutes of each other. 68 and a 74. Well, well done, boys. Well deserved. So, congrats on them. Right now, I'm back in the swim. It's about 2:30. Had a shower, had a skirt about, and I actually weren't going to be in a great rush to get the rods back out, but I think I'm going to now. Yeah, let's get them out. Caught up with Dennis and Mark. So, nice couple of hours skirting around. It was nice to chill out, but see those two big fish. Brilliant. So now I need to get one of them myself and all. Let's get on with it.
Well, just gone 3. Rods are back out. All to play for. 2 nights to go. Quiet night last night, but what a morning for the boys. So just shows you bites anytime.
Well, I think you can see the mist behind me. It's 7:30 Friday morning now. And again, that was another really quiet night. But I did hear the fish again to the right. And Ed, he heard some fish in front of him. I didn't hear him in front of me. But quiet a night. You know, last couple of days been really quiet for me. But still all to play for. So, approaching bite time. But then again, bite time can be any time here right now, so who knows. Oh, I could do with a fish, that's for sure.
There's Ed rebaiting in 18. Could all change for him. Been quiet in 18. Lucky was in there previous to Ed for 2 weeks for 3 fish. But that did include a 78, so happy days. Ed's just had the small one. About 9:30, this mist still ain't cleared. Well, just gone 1:00 Friday, rebaited, and hopefully I'm rebaiting again because I've had one. And I've put the 4th rod back out down this margin, which I've been catapulting some boilies to for the last 3 days. So, just in that sort of wind line out there, about 25 yards, I would say. But anyway, this is the scene, and let's hope we get another opportunity. Would be nice. All I need now, bloody bream. Just had 2 bream on the 1 rod. Put the rod back out there, I'll get another one. That's it, I've got to move it. Bloody thing. Yeah, jamming themselves on a 24 mil boilie. Look at these boilies. Right, look at the boilies. Yeah, look at that. They're just jamming themselves on you. Can't get it. You can't force that in a 2-pound bream's mouth. But just what I don't need. I'm just gonna sit back, enjoy the sun, take in the ambience. Bloody bream. 4:30 Friday. Just having an early dinner. Feels good for another bite. Really does. Yeah, let's just see if we can make it happen.
little common. Oh, got my chick again. Little Quasimodo common.
Well, my last evening on Rainbow, peg 17, still all to play for. What a week, and it ain't over.
Well, 8:30 Saturday morning. Just had a bream. That got the heart going. Otherwise, quiet night. Got one rod out. Finish this cup of tea, get that in, and then we'll be off to the clubhouse, shower and get back. But yeah, cracking week. And whilst it slowed up the second half, yeah, can't complain. Had a cracking time. So cheers, peg 17. Cheers, Rainbow.
What a peg.
Well, that familiar parting shot. What a week, what a swim, what a lake. Let's get home, save the synopsis for that. It's a bit noisy here, this traffic. And yeah, long journey as usual, but as I always say, can't start easier when you've had a great week. So yeah, let's get home. Well, guys, I've been back a couple of days now and drying out that gear. I don't think I've ever been so wet. Or my gear, I weren't wet, thanks to my waterproofs. But, yeah, that was a challenging week at Rainbow. But you know what? I had a great week. My first time in peg 17, I loved it. And I hope that came across on the video. You were on tenterhooks the whole time. And I had the good fortune of 10 bites and landed 10 fish. So I was well happy with that, and I think that's more down to, you know, fishing it the right way, thanks to the advice from a few of the lads, especially Kev and Jordan, who, you know the peg well, as well as 18. And yeah, Ed, it was nice to catch up with you too in 18. So yeah, cracking week, really enjoyed myself, very easy getting home. I know people have had challenges getting out to France and getting back and one thing and another. And it's not been without its challenges myself this year. But that was my last trip of the year. My next trip abroad will be end of March next year. But for now, as I say, cracking week. And yeah, heart thumping stuff really was. And you know, it's you go to Rainbow. Don't get me wrong. I've said before, you go to a lake. You know, if I go to a little pond, you know, 5 minutes from my house, the biggest one in there is 25 pound. You want to catch it. You know, at Rainbow, the biggest one in there might be 90 pound right now. You want to catch it. But I had two lovely 60 pounders, and that common. You know, what a fight. So yeah, that memory will stay with me for a long while. And you know, saw some lovely fish there. You know, the lads in 16. You know, they had two fish. I think they had two fish. They might have caught more, I don't know. But either way, you know, 68 and a 74. You know, that's Rainbow. Amazing place. And as I say, can't wait to go back. So, guys, thanks for watching this year. And, you know, I'm making plans for next year. Let's just hope COVID don't come around and bite us on the arse and everything else again this winter. You know, I've got my own thoughts on all of that. But the long and short of it is I do feel like we need to get on with life. But anyway, my videos ain't about discussing politics and, you know, people's rationales on world problems. My videos are about enjoying myself and sharing the experience with friends and the video. So again, thanks for watching, guys. And yeah, look forward to catching up next year with new adventures.